Hey guys, and welcome back to another train simulator video. And today we're going to be doing the Epsom to London Bridge service, starting at Epsom. As you can see, I am actually playing on a route which is currently in work in progress, so it will look pretty bad, as you can probably tell. But once it is completed, then I'm sure it will look amazing. And yeah. And we get to drive a part of the Southern network which I haven't driven before in this game, which is obviously the Epsom branch line. So let's just get the train set up first. Put the lights on. And yeah, we should be good to go. So we're doing all stops to London Bridge, I believe. Is there any signs here that's saying that this is Epsom station? I don't think so. But yeah, this is a heavily work in progress, so a lot of it hasn't been done yet, but I thought I'd do a quick video on it to showcase a potentially very good route when it does get completed. So we're going to be calling at Epsom, Ewell East, Cheam, Sutton, Carshalton Beaches, Wellington, Wadden, West Croydon, Norwich Junction and London Bridge. So we do actually have a fair few stations which are going to be new for Train Simulator. So I think we've still got another minute till we depart. But yeah, you can download this route from the Alan Thompson website, and it does come with a few scenarios where this is one of them. Yeah, we're driving a huge train. Actually, we're driving a 10 car train. I actually thought it was only an 8 car, so I don't think I can change it to a 10 car train, so we'll put 12 cars that. And yeah, we'll get going to our first station, which is Ewell East. So yeah, I'm still feeling really awful at the moment, so if you don't see me speaking much, then you'll know why. As we depart Epsom, we'd arrive at Ewell East at 15:50. So we are timed for all these stations, so probably best to like go as fast as possible up to the speed limit. So yeah, I will try to show as much scenery as I can, but as I mentioned, a lot of it hasn't been done yet, so unfortunately there isn't much to show at the moment. As we're now approaching Ewell East, platform 1. I wonder if our train will actually fit on this platform, because we are driving quite a long train. doesn't look like a very long platform either, so I think it only fit a 8-car train on this platform, I'm pretty sure. Now we are really early anyway, so we'll just coast into Ewell East. Yeah, it can only fit an 8-car train, as you can see. That's okay. Next station is Cheam, which we'll have a quick look at while we wait. Nothing's too far away from Ewell East. Oh, it just doesn't allow us, damn it. So close. So, started at Epsom. Cheam, going to Sutton, Carshalton Beaches, West Croydon, Norwich Junction, and all the way to London Bridge. And this train is ready to depart. Please mind the doors. Next station is Cheam. As we now approach Cheam. This is Cheam. You guys can let me know how accurate this is in terms of what there's already on the route. I unfortunately never been on this part of the route, so I wouldn't really know. The next station will be Sutton, where you can change for services towards Epsom Down. And other destinations on the subway network. Yellow signal, yes it is. So the signalling on this route might be a bit screwed up as well, so better in mind. I think we're gonna be late as we approach Sutton. Got massive downhill slope now, which... I mean, is there a massive downhill slope just before Sutton Station in real life? This seems like a huge slope, holy damn. I mean, this is probably the most steepest slope I've ever probably driven on train simulator, so that's crazy. I assume those tracks are for the Sutton loop, which go down there. Go check on the map actually. And this is the platforms for the line that goes towards Epsom Downs. I actually thought this scenario was from Epsom Downs to London Bridge, but it's actually Epsom, which is on the Dorking Line. Here, train. Just can't see it. I think he's gonna be approaching us, I believe. Yeah, there's one. That's probably going to Epsom Down. But we'll be continuing to our journey towards London Bridge. Next station is Carshalton Beaches. Time for a screenshot. Actually, that train's going back towards Epsom or even Dorking. Okay, looks like the 20 mile an hour speed limit isn't on the HUD, so didn't actually realize we had to go that slow, but. Thank you. Another thing that you can do on this route is actually drive the tram link between East Croydon and Mitcham Junction, or is it West Croydon? I think one of those two stations, basically. So there's actually a scenario for that, which I will be playing eventually once I can download it from the UK train sim website. Unfortunately, you have to wait in a queue to download things from that website, so I'm still waiting in the queue, so stay tuned for that. The Just Trains full Metropolitan line should be released by next week or the week after, hopefully, so I'll be busy with that. This is called Charlton Beaches. Why the station's called that, I have no idea. Next station is Wallington, followed by Wadden, West Croydon, Norwood Junction, and London Bridge. Now approaching Wallington. Might overshot this slightly, but I think it's just about okay. This is Wallington. Next station is Wadden. This is modern. Change it. Next station is West Croydon, where you can change for one on all ground services and other southern services and the tram link. As you can probably tell, the trembling is on this route, as you can see, with these red arrow keys, I guess. Only a small section of it is available, but I think, yeah, Mitcham Junction to West Croydon, I think that's the part line you can drive with a tramlink, which is a decent amount actually. I believe the scenario goes from Mitcham Junction to West Croydon, where the drive will take over towards New Eddington. Yeah, hopefully they will extend it all the way up towards Wimbledon. That would be pretty cool. Anyways, we're approaching West Croydon now. To depart at 16:11, so we're good. You don't really want to arrive too early. I can't see an all ground service there. It's actually been a really long time since I've driven to West Croydon in the game. Super early. Can't see a 4557 service. That's probably going to have some downs, I'm pretty sure. This is West Croydon. Yep, that's going to Epsom Downs, as I thought. And yeah, we've got a bit of a wait here, unfortunately. That was Croydon. So I'll quickly show you the whole map. So it's essentially the South London network. But now you can drive all the way towards Epsom, Epsom Downs. And obviously got the tram link, which you can see is highlighted. So that's Mitcham Junction. obviously that's down towards Brighton, but that's not part of the South London network. But yeah, you can drive from Mitcham Junction all the way to West Croydon and towards East Croydon via the tram link. We're going all the way to London Bridge. And we should depart in a few seconds from now. This train is ready to depart, please mind the doors. Next station is Norwood Junction, which is only 1.8 miles away, and we've got like 5 minutes, so I guess we'll just coast towards Norwood Junction because we'll probably get a red signal at some point. And after Norwood Junction, we got London Bridge, so getting towards the end of this journey. If you want me to play the other scenarios included on this route, then please let me know. Or do you want me to save them until the whole route becomes properly made with all the scenery and all that? Which I kind of want to do anyway, because it's a lot better with scenery and all the signs and all that. Okay. We'll be shortly arriving at Norwood Junction, where you can change for London Overground services, Thames Link services, and other Southern services. Please mind the gap between the train and the platform edge. Class 170 turbo star. I wonder if both doors open at the station in real life. Because obviously you can open the doors, there are platforms on either side of the train. So I guess in real life it would make sense to open both sides of the doors, I guess. Kind of feel like we're on the wrong platform anyway. I think this is just for all ground services. Well, National Rail services are on that part of the route, but anyways. After this we've got London Bridge. Where's this train going to? Oh, that's not in service. Fair enough. Let's get going. So we're going to be switching tracks onto the fast lines. As we're calling it on all ground lines. We'd stop at each and every station between here and New Cross Gates. So 8 miles to go and we've got just under 11 minutes, so we should be reaching it on time. Got 377 here. 438, so I'm sorry, waiting for us, and a 455 here waiting for us as well. It's going to London Bridge as well, so I wonder which one of these trains will go first. I assume the 455 is going to be stopping at all stations, whereas the Finting service will be skipping all these stations, so there must be some delays on the line. Miles to go. Going down also, we will pick up speed anyways, so no need to accelerate. Gate now, so we'll be approaching London Bridge very soon. Single yellow, so I think we should be just about okay. Even though it was approved, but I will this away just in case. Wait here and see what's exactly what we're waiting for. So goal is on lag like crazy now. Oh. I mean, we've got green signal here, so yeah, I think we should be okay. I mean, nothing ahead of us, so and some of these signals might be a bit screwed up anyways, so let's just assume that and hopefully it will be okay. I mean, we've got only like 3 minutes to arrive anyways, so red signal as well. At 16:20 then anyway, so the platform should be cleared. Approaching London Bridge, where this train will terminate. All change, all change. The train terminates here. We've got class 700. Same thing service, look very nice. So you probably tell that London Bridge looks kind of different. I find this London Bridge looks a lot cooler than the other one. All change, this train terminates here. So once this route does become finished, then we should have a completely new London Bridge station, which will be really cool to see. But yeah, Sonora is completed. And that was the 1545 Epsom to London Bridge. So the route is called Epsom to London Victoria plus Sutton and Mole Valley, if you're wondering. But yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If you did, give it a like, share it with your friends, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye guys.